The next step has been taken in the rebirth of a Lancaster County landmark destroyed by floodwaters. Floodwaters washed away the Siegrist Mill Bridge outside Mount Joy in September 2011. Now, nearly 2 years later, a new bridge with some of the old features has been put back in place. News 8's Jerry Gish is live at the site with more on what's going on. Jerry.
Hi, Susan. You know, neighbors who live in this area say it was devastating when the historic cover bridge was washed away by those floodwaters, but a much different feeling out here today. Take a look behind me. You can see for the first time in more than a year and a half, there's now a bridge crossing the Chickies Creek here along Siegrist Road. There's still some work to do. Siding has to be put on, a roof as well, but the main structure, the framework of the new Siegrist Mill Bridge is now in place. The bridge was assembled here on the site over the past few weeks, and this morning the 50-ton bridge, that's 50,000 pounds, was slowly lifted into the air and swung by a large crane toward its destination. The old bridge was built in 1885, and this new one was built exactly like the old one, with a burr arch design. Dozens of people came out to watch all this today, including neighbors who were happy to see a brand new cover bridge being put into place.
Everyone on this road played in the bridge and enjoyed it. Wrote their name in it, which we shouldn't have. Put her initials, and it's just beautiful to see it sitting there near our home.
It's a once in a lifetime event. It's something that I never thought I'd ever see. An actual bridge being placed over a river. I didn't know it was possible.
Now, some new abutments were built as well on both sides of the creek, and this bridge will sit 2 feet higher than the old one to hopefully prevent any future flood damage. So again, some more work needs to be done, but I talked to the crew after all this was complete, and they say they're very happy with how all this went. As you can imagine, it's a little nerve-wracking when you're taking a 50-ton bridge and putting it into place, but they said things went well this morning. And it's going to be a little bit of time yet, though, before you're going to be able to drive across it. They're hoping to have it open to car traffic, as one of the neighbors mentioned, horse and buggy traffic, by July 1st. At the latest.